بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
ولقد جئناهم بكتاب فصلناه على علم هدى ورحمة لقوم
الحمد لله ربي ليهتك باسمك قلبي الحمد لله الحمد لله حمدا إلهي وشكرا أنت يا معبود يا من يا من جل قدرا جل قدرا لك الحمد صمتا لك الحمد فرضا لك الحمد خفقا حثيثا ونبضا لك الحمد صمتا لك الحمد فرضا لك الحمد خفقا حثيثا ونبضا فأنت رامي وأنت انسجامي مع الكون والأمر لولاك قهرا الحمد لله الحمد لله الحمد لله الحمد لله الحمد لله
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته جزاك الله خير تسعة أندستان بعثي دون أندستان باللانجويج ديسكريبشن إن شاء الله أول سنة في أمو في دونيس أنا وقفي أعجيزي أول سنة بسنة في دونيس إمام عزي تفضل جزاك الله خير
إن الحمد لله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين I praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and He's the only one worthy of praise. I seek His help, His guidance and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge on Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah Rabbil Alameen. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Fear Allah and don't die unless you are in the state of Islam. After this, I greet you all with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. And before I start my 5 minutes Iman, I would like from my heart to welcome a new Muslim, a new sister to take his Shahada, to testify to the oneness of Almighty Allah and the finality of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is a new day for you, sister. It is a new life for you. And believe it or not, it is almost a feast for us. It is almost like Eid, a holiday, a special occasion for all of us. It is our pleasure, our happiness that we see in you embracing Islam. It is a newborn for you. You are a newborn person by testifying La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. You are a new person in this life. All what happened in your life is past, is you are forgiven for anything that happened by you or from you since you've been born until this moment. It is a great blessing from Allah that you took Shahada. That means Allah had selected you. Allah had chose you. Allah turned towards you in mercy. Allah had opened your eyes as well as your heart. You had purified your heart from the shirk. You had purified your heart from associating partner beside Allah, from claiming that God has a son or has an equal or a partner. So may Allah bless you and bless your heart. You had purified your tongue by saying, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, Ashhadu anna Muhammadur Rasulullah. Your tongue today had said the most important word and the most important sentence in the whole life, to testify, to acknowledge Almighty Allah. Allah had opened your mind today and for you to get to see the wisdom that He chose you, selected you to make you one of this million and billions of Muslims on this earth. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue in blessing you. May Allah Almighty strengthen you, make you a strong believer. May Allah forgive your past sin. May Allah make your future better than your past. Congratulations from our hearts. Congratulations in my behalf, in behalf of my center, in behalf of my mosque. Congratulations on behalf of everybody in this room. Congratulations to you from everybody on the Pal Talk, from everybody on any of the channels that we're broadcasting live today. May Allah reward you. May Allah bless you. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue blessing those who became a reason and cause for you to take your shahada. It is a day that you have to record it and never forget it, because today you became a Muslim. You became a person who submit to the will of Almighty Allah. You had acknowledged your Creator that He is one alone. You had acknowledged your Prophet to be your leader. You had acknowledged Islam to be your way of life. Alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah. All praise is due to Allah. All praise and thanks is due to Almighty, your Creator and our Creator, Creator of all things, that He had shown you the way. It is our pleasure, sister. It is our happiness. Everybody feel joyous that knowing that you had said, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. You should be the happiest person in this life today, as well as those who took Shahada. Every minute, every second, somebody, man or a woman, young or old, someplace on this planet is testifying to the oneness of Allah and the finality of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue showering you with His blessings. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make your day better than yesterday and make your tomorrow better than today. That Allah continue blessing you. I advise you sincerely from your heart. From today, you need to focus in your Islam to make it your main priority in this life and to prepare for the hereafter, for you to get to know more every day, increase your knowledge, and every day try to be a better Muslim, inshallah. With all happiness, with all joys, I say it again, congratulations, and congratulations again, and congratulations until the day of judgment. May Allah bless you, and may Allah bless those who became the cause of your Islam, and may Allah make us a means and ways that will bring other people to Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us a means and ways to save people from hellfire, to get them from the darkness to the light. Ameen. And ameen, and ameen, wa akhiru da'wana, and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Inshallah, my dear respected brothers and sisters, if it's okay with you, Sister Baraka, you can tell me, inshallah, one, if it's okay, or two, if it's not okay. It seemed like you want to continue in the feast and the celebration for the Shahada. It's fine with me. But if you want me to give my 5 minutes, Iman, inshallah, I will go ahead with it. So please let me know. Free country, free speech. Yes, you can, of course.
يثبتكم جميعا على الحق وأن يهدي غير المسلمين الإسلام وأن يثبت المسلمين الجذر على الإسلام إن شاء الله. Okay. There are some people I don't know what they are in this room. Please pay attention. There are people coming here to swear and to curse in the text. Read the text, please, and reward those people. Allahumma ameen. Sheikh, your sound was breaking. And I don't know if you're recording the lesson or something. It would be nice if you report and come back. So maybe the sound will be fine when you start talking. That's all I wanted to say. صوت يتقطع بعض الأحيان ربما تكون تسجل الدرس أو شيء حتى ما يكون في تقطيع في الدرس. نحن نعرف شيء زبر نحن نقوم بالواجب والحمد لله ميت كم شخص نحن لن ينطق الشهادة نحن لا نتركهم بعد الشهادة نحن نعلمهم الغسل والصلاة ونرسلهم للمسجد ونشجع ونرسلهم كتب الحمد لله الحمد لله هذا إن شاء الله هذا ما نفعله بعد إعلان الشهادة وهذا ما قلت لها قبل قليل إن شاء الله ولا نطلب منهم أن يأتوا للمايك ينطقوا الشهادة بعدين نتركهم لا المسؤولية الحمد لله إن شاء الله one step at a time don't worry about you cannot do everything the same time step by step إن شاء الله he will do it جزاك الله خيرا أوكي تفضل إمام عدلي ما الله سبحانه وتعالى if you want to report if you don't want it it's okay because your sound was breaking that's all If you are recording something, I don't want the sound to be to break while you start your lesson. Allahumma ameen. Would you ask for the sake of Allah?
Inshallah, I really don't know what is the problem with the connection for the last 2 days. But if it break, you can read that me and you can continue doing what you want to do. It's no problem, inshallah. Is it already breaking? Subhanallah. I don't know what I can do. Okay, let me... What about now? Maybe if I talk soft, restart... Restart the whole thing. Okay. Okay, Allah al-musta'an. Khairan, inshallah. Zakumullah khairan. Be back in a minute and a half, inshallah. Finish or fish? سبحان الله الحمد لله لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله سبحان الله الحمد لله لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله اللهم صل على محمد النبي وأزواجه أمهات المؤمنين وذريته وآل بيته كما صليت على آل إبراهيم إنك حميد
they do think that not from Islam. Okay, the Sheikh is here, inshallah, Imam Adli. You can add him to your file, sister, and when you have any questions, you can ask him. I hope your sound will be okay now. Yeah, Imam Adli. ودعينا يا إيمان لا تنساني من صالح دعائك بارك الله فيك. Okay, raise your hand now if you're ready. Another fish. Pray for me every day, fish. Pray for me every day, fish. يا خالة بركة. The fish today. Take my.
إن شاء الله أسأل الله أن يعطيك حوت مو بس فش حوت كبير إن شاء الله لعل الله يأتي بما يسمونه البرنس أو يأتي بمن هو أفضل منه إن شاء الله ويكون على يدك إن شاء الله. If the sound is not good you can red dot it and don't worry about it, okay؟ يعني انتهى وقت المعجزات. No more miracles. I could not help it. But inshallah, I say Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala Rasulillah. With 5 minutes, Iman, and already time is over. But inshallah, we have a short verse, but it's very important related to Iman. This is Surah number 23 and verse number 1, which Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Success are for the believers, or the believers must eventually win through. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying this as a fact that no doubt about it. وَمَنْ أَصْدَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ قِيلَ لَأَحَدٍ وَمَنْ أَصْدَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ حَدِيثَ لَأَحَدٍ. Nobody, no one better than Allah in speech, no one more truthful than Allah. Allah said, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Success is for the believers. If you are Muslim, if you are a believer, if they testify to the oneness of Allah and finality of the Prophet ﷺ, if you are a believer, acting on faith and behaving according faith, you are a winner. You are the winner. And if Allah is saying you are winner, you are winner with no doubt. Okay? With no doubt. And there is a success in this life and there is a success in the hereafter. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't say which is success. That mean both success. Success will be for you if you are a believer. You will have success in this life. You will have success in the hereafter. So if you want to be successful, you have to be a believer. And تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله. تؤمن باليوم الآخر. تؤمن بالجنة والنار. الذين يؤمنون بالغيب. تؤمن بالقدر. You want to be a successful in this life. You want to be successful in the hereafter, you have to hold to Iman. You have to live Iman. You have to practice faith. Believing in Allah, to believe in the angels of Allah, to believe in the books of Allah, to believe in the messengers of Allah, to believe in resurrection after death, to believe in the fate and predestination. Allah promised you success. So do your job so you can get the success in this life and the hereafter. الحديث الخامس الحديث الخامس عن أبي أمامة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من أحب لله وأبغض لله وأعطى لله ومنع لله فقد استكمل الإيمان. صحيح سنن أبو داود. The Prophet of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم will say the hadith again in العربية. من أحب لله وأبغض لله وأعطى لله ومنع لله فقد استكمل الإيمان. Abu Umama, may Allah be pleased with him, reported that the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, If anyone loves for Allah's sake, hates for Allah's sake, gives for Allah's sake, and withhold for Allah's sake, he will have perfected faith. So, we as Muslims, our moves, our steps, everything we do have to be according the way of Allah and for the sake of Allah. Not for fame, not for gain, not for shuhrah, not for riya, not for sum'ah. And sometimes that we may do things with our hands, with our limbs. But the intention is the most important thing, because your intention is what determines how good and how sound is your deed. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whosoever gives for the sake of Allah, gives what? Gives information, gives knowledge, gives money, gives food, anything that you're giving, why are you doing it? If you're doing it for Allah, alhamdulillah. Why you are not giving anymore? It's because somebody says something make you mad, or you stop giving because Allah. So whenever you give, you're giving for Allah. When you withhold for Allah. So if you see the person doing the right thing and you support him or her, you're doing it for Allah. So if you come as example in the room to assist, you don't come here for people to see your dedication. You come here to seek knowledge for the sake of Allah. You come to give hand to be an admin, not to corrupt the room, but to help the room to be open day and night. Now this is for Allah. So whatever movement that you're doing, even is not given and taken, even more deeper than this. Something that you could not see it as a human being, your heart. What about the heart? What about the feeling? Why you loving so and so? Why you disliking so and so? Why you love this brother? Why you hate this brother? Why you love this woman? Why you hate this woman? So our feeling, it have to be also for the sake of Allah. We need purity in our deed. We need purity, transparency in our action. And we need it in our intention. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whosoever loves for the sake of Allah, hates for the sake of Allah. You love a person, love it for Allah's sake. Love because he making salah. Love because he cover properly. Love because he helping the Muslims. Love them because he teaching. And when you hate somebody, you hate the person because the evil, because the shirk, because the kufr that they doing, because the bid'ah they teaching. So our love and our hate have to be for Allah. Now if we do this for our deeds and our emotion became for Allah, now we perfected our faith. We completed our faith. So from this hadith we understand that some people have complete faith and some people have deficiency in their iman. So al-iman yazidu wa yanqus. Yazidu bil-ta'a wa yanqusu bil-ma'asiyah. As a result of this, he found some people, they have a full iman, a complete iman, perfect faith. And he found some people, they have deficiency in their faith. Therefore, every Muslim, male and female, they need to learn what it strengthens their faith and what decreases their faith. So Islam encourages loving for Allah's sake. Islam encouraging hating in Allah's cause. Islam encouraging giving for Allah and only for Allah, and Islam encouraging withholding for the sake of Allah. And also this hadith shows us the importance and the serious of the intention which is done by the heart. And also we have to understand the same way our body go ups and down to make prayer, our heart also can be worshiping Allah. We have to understand that Iman increase and decrease. Therefore, if we want to complete our faith, we need to love for Allah, hate for Allah, gives for Allah, withhold for Allah. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this 5 minutes Iman became a means for the speaker as well as the listener to increase our faith and to improve our condition and to make us a better believer, inshallah. Looking forward to see you again tomorrow. Again, congratulations to our new sister. Welcome to Islam. Welcome to Iman. Welcome in your Muslim family, that everywhere, in the east, in the west, in the north, in the south, above the ground, on the moon, everywhere, welcome. May Allah strengthen you, and may Allah bless your day and your future. Ameen. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك.